even be? Because what to do is a very painful question. You are having your exams tomorrow, but you are very sleepy. So if you ask yourself what I need to do, your brain will immediately answer you, go get some sleep and refreshed and then study, etc., etc. But if you understand one thing, that for me these exams are very, very important. So if I won't sleep, I won't die. See yourself in the mirror. Are you dying? Are you gonna die if you won't sleep for one night, etc.? Things like that. Give yourself some time. Give yourself good questions so that your brain gives you scope and gives you energy to survive for that particular field. Some people are ready to take the temporary current pain, but for the larger outcome they want in their life to happen. Psychologist says that the language you use produce your emotions. So what language you are using will give you energy to survive through the whole process of your achievement of goals. And your focus is based on what questions you ask yourself. So how did Bill Gates change his whole economic system? He was a software designer. He didn't ask himself, how can I build a good software? He asked, how do we become the intelligence that controls all computers worldwide? I repeat, he asked, how do we become the intelligence that controls all computers worldwide? If that's the outcome, the action will be to build a best software. And so he is the richest person in the whole world. So when it comes to planning or dhasu planning related to your goal, I want you to ask yourself three questions. And that is, the three questions related to this RPM system is rapid planning method, or you say result planning method, or you can also say it as result, purpose and massive action plan. So the first part is the result, that is, what do you actually want? Or what's your outcome, or what's your result, or what's your result you are after? And the more clearer you are, the more powerful it becomes. If you are so very general that I want money, so someone will say, take 10 rupees and your goal is completed. Or if you say, I want to feel a bit better, so even if you are like do meditation, you are better. So what exactly do you want? The clarity is power. So what do you want? Make it, or what result do you want? Make it that clearer that it becomes more powerful to you. And the second question is purpose. Why do you want it? Success depends 80% upon why do you want that particular thing, 20% upon how do you want it. Like if you say I want $1 million, or if you want to say that I want to feed 300 different children, that is what do you want. But the emotional drive behind your outcome should be so powerful. Say for example, if I am throwing a hairpin upon you, it won't affect you. But if I tie to that particular hairpin, if I tie a rod, a longer rod, and if I throw that particular rod upon you and it goes through your heart, that will affect you more. And that particular rod behind your powerful pin is the purpose. Why do you want that particular thing? And then when you ask yourself these two questions, that what the outcome I am after and why do I want it, when you are clear about your result and your purpose, then your brain will give you many, many different plans. That is the massive action plan, or the map. The map are many ways. It's not a single way. So don't confuse yourself with activities and outcomes. Outcomes are different and activity is different. Activity will change from day to day, will change depending upon circumstances, will change upon your mood, upon your mindset, will change according to people around you. But your outcome and your purpose won't change. And if your outcome is so very clear, say for example, your brain is like a server mechanism in a bomb or a missile. In olden days, you shoot a missile, target is going and you missed
the target and you missed it. But today the system is changed. What happened is if the missile misses the target, it changes the route and it follows the target through the particular way. Similarly, your brain, if it knows the outcome and if the purpose is so very powerful, it's not just that I want $1 million because, and you keep on repeating, why do you want it, but it's not that powerful. It should be that very powerful that it drives you, it won't let you sleep, and it keeps you alive or keeps you in movement so that you do that particular actions. And even if you miss that particular action, change your route, find out more, plan out more questions to your brain so that it find out more different maps to follow your purpose.